Do you have any regrets?
No. Eat mac and cheese every day. No, I think. No, no regrets.
The only regrets I have is I'm like pretty gelat with mac and cheese every day.
My name is Samuel and his Fami. We are very close friends. We have been working for 2 years in total. Really.
Yeah, 2 years. Started off as a home-based business because I quit my full-time job to take care of my mom. Then I needed a part-time job. Then I met him. Then we decided we need to open a brick and mortar. This is where we start. Mac and cheese has never been the main highlight of a dish. It's always been a side dish to accompany a main dish. I've always been a fan of cheese. I love all sorts of cheese. Naturally, it came to that. I want to do a mac and cheese dish that is different from what I've faced so far. It's been abysmal, lah. That's why I wanted to do a mac and cheese dish which I myself can eat. Most importantly, you have to like the dish.
For us, we become the hawker, so we put it at a reasonably price and a good amount of volume for people to try.
And we pride ourselves at using premium cheese. When you taste it, you can actually taste the different type of cheeses that we use.
We just discussed that let's make mac and cheese a niche through R&D and trying our best. We just came out with all these 5 flavors.
I want to include different cultures that we have in Singapore. We have the classic, which is of course the authentic ones that we started out with. When I started the brick and mortar, we wanted something different. So we decided to do Korean. Korean is very popular. We did butter chicken, Indian cuisine, mixture of North and South Indian.
Basically, all the inspiration is just trying to cater to as many people as we can. Till today, we realize that everyone has different tastes. Like, we are quite surprised that normally when people come to us, they ask like, what's your best seller? What is great here? It's very hard for me to say because there's so many different regulars that like different things. We started from Instagram. Everything requires like photos, Insta stories. My idea to him is like, since you are marketing through an online platform, features and like, you know what people say nowadays, food porn and how like, oh my god, this looks great, I would like to try it. Coming today, we have about 12k followers on Instagram. Purely from our online supporters, which we really appreciate, like, this how we make our store start in the first place. They encouraged us to start one. He needed someone to like help him with the marketing and basically like taking nice photos lah. But at that point of time, it was just a friend thing. It just slowly lead me into the business.
Yeah, the first day was a lot. The queue was really, really long. We weren't expecting that much of people to like come to our store. So when they finally appeared, right, we were like, oh, okay, yeah, we didn't have enough.
We were still so worried. We were like, oh my god, we're gonna fail.
Yeah, we didn't have
no
enough.
No one's gonna appear.
I'm pretty much a mama's boy, lah, as you can see. And he's a mama's boy also. And of course, my mom likes to cook a lot. And that inspired me to like actually start a business lah, to pay homage to her. Yeah. So the first time I let you try was pretty bad. I still wasn't happy with it. I wasn't satisfied with it. I mean, like, I can see from the look of his face like when he tried it. He was like, can be better. I was like, yep, okay, time to go back. At the point of time, I only used like 2 types of cheeses. I didn't have that je ne sais quoi, you know, that X factor.
As we come in, right, we always price ourselves upon using like quality ingredients. It's like a bit pointless if you want to put it at a lower price and then you give a subpar quality food. And then it's like, there's no point. But even when you want to give a premium quality, but you give a too low of a price, you're not earning, and so there's also no point. So and then we like discuss and everything, we decide to range between the price range, which is like $8 to $10 max. The funny thing is that a lot of people don't understand like cheese can be actually very expensive. We did try to like price it reasonably. I mean, if we can, I think there will be tons of more other flavors and more ingredients on the side. We want to give more, but it's just that it's in a hawker setting, so this is like try and give the best that we can at a reasonable price later. It's really heartwarming and to hear people say like, oh wow, well, I really appreciate that you use like authentic cheese. Like we hear this kind of thing, we're like, oh my god, people understand everything. So it just feel like what we are doing is correct and what the effort is worthwhile.
The most rewarding part is seeing your customers being happy. Sometimes they wait quite long because it can be quite tedious to queue. You apologize to them, sorry, no, it's okay. Like, and then when they receive the food, you can see like joy in their face. And then it makes me smile, lah, knowing that what we make, someone appreciates it and we like it.
I'm happy because my mom and dad, they are very traditional. So when I started hawker, I'm quite surprised that they didn't like say, hey, why didn't you get like a bank job, like an office job? They actually quite supportive. So just go for it, try for a year or something. If you can make it, just make it.
My dad is happy. He's been telling all his friends like, my son opened a shop, Amoy Street. Yeah, because my dad doesn't talk a lot. He's a very reserved person. So seeing that warms my heart.
But no regrets, lah. We're quite happy we took this route because we learned a lot. It just feels great when there's people appreciating what we do. This will always stay. Like, we will always want this to be someone people remember us for, our first brick and mortar as a hawker concept store.
We envision our brand to go as far as shopping malls, sprouting everywhere, you know.
It'll still be the same logo. If one day it happens, it means that we make it. And one day we are still here, it's still think we make it. Because this store will always be our baby and what we started with.